Alright, now I've already scraped last night's clutch off and the other day's clutch off the back of the tank. Just going to show you all how I set up my hatcheries. Sorry, think of the word there. Incubators, rather. Incubators, hatcheries, whatever you want to call it. I take paper towel, single piece, fold it in half. I dip it in quickly, just enough to get it wet. Let it drip a little bit. It's gonna be hard to chew one-handed. And then, put it upside down so that the wet piece is at the top. Fold it in half. The long way. Here, we'll use the light. Like this, so that the wet piece is now sitting on top of the dry piece. It's much easier to do two-handed. Then we flip it so the two dry pieces are touching. Alright, then you just squeeze it. I should get a little bit wetter here because I lost a little bit of moisture trying to fumble with it here. I should get it wet enough for your hatchery here. You do want to use your tank water just so that, you know, you're giving them the same thing they're going to be going into. Right, whether that's your grow out tank or, and yes, again, this is all done in my bedroom. So yes, I'm sitting on my bed right now looking at my tank. I literally sit this far away from my tank all night long. Yeah. Fish room, I don't got one. I got bedroom. And on the other side of my bed is the 150 gallon. And then on the floor over there is Chief's. But my room's kind of messy, so I don't really want to show that. I gotta finish my laundry. But I then take, yes, I'm a professional, I use my knees here. As carefully as you can, you take your clutch and place it inside whatever you're using for your hatchery. I'm using Betta cups or to-go cups for plants that they give you at PetSmart, Petco, that sort of deal. Yes, I know, I try to support my local fish store, but it's 36 miles away, and I don't like their fish room. They don't take care of their tanks very well. They leave dead fish lying there all the time, and I don't appreciate that, so I won't support them. But there we go. We got two fresh ones there. One that's close to hatching, so it's off here by itself. And I've got two here that are roughly around the same lay date. Same with these. They're roughly about the same time frame apart. So I'll probably end up shifting. I did take the ones that were in here and put them in the tank. But now I haven't seen them for a while. Every once in a while, I might see one climbing the side of the tank and then it disappears and I don't see it again. So I'm not sure what happened. I'm probably not going to be doing that again though. Just, oh, there is that one, or is that a piece of poo? No, it looks like a piece of poo. Okay. So I'm not going to show that. Looks like a piece of poo stuck to the side. I'll have to clean that off in a little bit. Not seeing any over on that side either. So, not a whole lot. Just wanted to show how to do that. Because, well, I feel that the instructions of wring it out and, you know, keep it wet but not too wet, or it's kind of a little wonky, you know? It's weird instructions. A lot of people do put a paper towel, a dry paper towel, in between this layer and that one. I don't, simply because the last time I did that, it took a really long time for the clutch to hatch, the first one. And I wanted to see if it would make a difference on this one, and it seems to have. It's a week behind that one, and I don't know, it seems to be pretty close to hatching, as well as the other one was, so, I mean... I don't know, maybe it makes a difference, maybe it doesn't. I don't know, I'm gonna find out. Alright, and that's the day of the tank. And this is as the tank cycles. Have a good day.